Hi everyone, hope you're doing amazing today. We're doing really well, thank you. My name is Carolina Fonseca Jimenez. I focus on doing children's books that promote love, unity, and peace, and we also interpret our dreams here. The reason that we interpret our dreams is because when we do, we are connecting with our subconscious, and when we share them, we connect with one another on a more profound level. So guys, I've taken all of the dream requests you've sent in, and I've created a list. We've tallied them up, and we've got our top five that were sent in for 2019, so we're going to go over that today. Now, before I go over the symbols and the interpretation, I want to remind you that we can always help guide you in the interpretation of your dream, but you were the only one that was there. You were the only one that experienced those emotions and those feelings, so only you know your true dream language, okay? Remember that you always have the power to interpret your own dream. I just help guide you with it, all right? And it's my pleasure to do it, by the way. So let's go ahead and get started. So whenever we dream about this particular symbol, this has been one that's been sent in like almost every single week by one of you, okay? And that is dreaming of exploring a house. Now, as you know, whenever you dream that you're exploring anything, specifically a house in your dream, it's a representation of the dreamer and how you view yourself. So for example, if you're outside of the house, right? If you're outside of the house and you can't get in, but you're just looking at the external, you know, surface of the house and how it's painted and all of that, that is simply a reflection of how you view yourself currently, okay? You can't get in the house for whatever reason, that's simply just letting you know that you're connected to yourself in the external part of you, right? All of those things that you do, all of the actions that you do, you're connected to yourself in that way, but you're having trouble connecting with your subconscious. The reason that we know this is because in the dream world, whenever you're able to enter your house, enter this particular house, you start exploring, right? You start exploring the various rooms, you start exploring the basement, which is the subconscious, you start exploring those different rooms, maybe your personal room, your bedroom, that would be more of a personal connection. And then whenever you're exploring the attic, that's more the conscious, the most aware part of you, right? The most aware self. So if you're not able to even enter the house, that simply is letting us know that there's a little bit of trouble connecting with yourself on that profound level, all right? Now, if you're able to go inside the house and explore these various rooms and open the doors and all of that, that lets us know that you're at least able to connect with your subconscious. You're able to see what's going on. You're able to see some of the issues that you may perceive in your waking life, okay? We know this if you're able to enter various rooms. Most importantly, if you're able to like go to the basement and explore the basement, that is a representation of the deepest subconscious, okay? So sometimes whenever you're going to the basement, there may be things down there that scare you or that frighten you, okay? Have you ever noticed that? The reason that that happens is because we keep the like those most, those deepest secrets, those kinds of concerns, those worries, those things that have been gathering up in our life year through year through year, those kinds of things you will find in the basement, okay? So if they, if you go down there, let's say you go down there and there's like this huge, like, I don't know, monster that jumps out at you or something like that, that is simply a reflection of how you view the subconscious, how you view some of your problems. You are fearful of them, right? You're not fully ready to, I guess to take them on, okay? And we know this if the monster in there scares you and you run away from it, that kind of thing, okay? But basically, let me keep on track because I can like keep making this stuff from the dreams you've sent me. But basically, whenever you dream of a house, it's a representation of you, of the dreamer. But remember, this is like the most important thing that I always say, always, 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 is that your feelings are going to guide you in any dream interpretation, okay? The symbolism, yes, it's important, but more important than any symbolism, than anything that you will see in your dream, is the feelings associated with what you're seeing, okay? Because I can see a house and feel a certain way, right? I can see, let's say that I see a particular house and someone I know sees a very similar house, but I feel different when I see that house and they feel different when they see that house. So this symbol of this house is going to mean something totally different depending on the dreamer and their feelings and their emotions during the dream, okay? So always remember that. All right, that's the first one, the house one. Now, let's go to the second one, and I made my list because sometimes I forget what they are. All right, oh, driving. Okay, driving is a really cool one too, because whenever you're driving, that is simply symbolic for like, you know, I'm in control, I know where I'm going down this path, right? Now, depending on how you're feeling when you're driving is going to be the key to interpreting your dream. But basically, whenever you're driving yourself, that just lets us know that you're in control. Now, if for whatever reason you're in the backseat and someone is driving you and you don't have any control over where you're going, that's a representation of how you're running your life too, right? Maybe you've taken the backseat and maybe you're letting other people do things for you, and sometimes that can be a good thing, but sometimes it can be like they're running the life for you, okay? They are choosing where to turn, they are choosing where to go, and you're kind of just in the back along for the ride, okay? So dreams like that are kind of like a wake-up call, letting you know, take control. Take control of your own life. You can direct yourself in wherever, you know, direction you want to go. You can make the turns that you want to do, but you have to take the driver's seat back. Okay, those dreams are incredibly important because they are a wake-up call. Okay, so if you're dreaming, excuse me, still a cold by the way. So if you're dreaming that you are not driving the car in the dream, try to go to the front and drive. And the reason we do this is because whenever you're doing that, you are practicing that kind of creativity in your dream state. Okay, the most subconscious state. If you're able to have a vivid dream, a lucid dream where you're in the back seat of the car and then you physically move yourself to the front and start driving your own car. Guys, the symbolism to that and the connection you make with your subconscious is so profound because what you're saying is, no, I'm not allowing this person to drive my car anymore. I am going to take control and drive my own car. Okay. And that connection at the subconscious level, guess what, will reflect in your waking life. That's why it's so important to interpret your dreams and to understand what they're trying to tell you. And even more importantly, whenever you're able to get to that point, to have a lucid dream so that way you can change the way that your mind operates, okay? If usually you allow other people to drive your car, you allow other people to run your life, but in your lucid dream you're able to change that, that's going to reflect out here too, okay? Remember that because it's just one person, one being, and if you practice those things at the most subconscious level, that will appear in your waking life. All right, let's move on to the next one because I don't want this video to be too crazy long. Third one are snakes. Okay, so many of you have been dreaming about snakes coming at you, snakes biting you. There was one of you that even dreamt about three snakes like biting you, like one, two, three, after another, okay. Okay, the animals in the dream are so important because they are a reflection a lot of the time of the people that surround us, okay, and the situations that we're in. So for example, if you're a lover of snakes, if you love, 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 love snakes, and you see snakes in your dream, that's good. That's good for you. It just means that, you know, you're in good energy. You're in your kind of vibe, right? You're surrounded by people like you that you like, if you like snakes, okay? However, well, and if you feel good during the dream too, by the way, okay? But now, if you don't like snakes, you're fearful of snakes, and in the dream you feel afraid of these snakes, and they start kind of coming at you, that's not the same interpretation. Okay, it's not the same interpretation, one, because you're interpreting it differently based on your feelings and emotions, right? And then also you don't like snakes to begin with. So if you're having this kind of a dream and you fall under this category, that's simply letting you know that in this moment you are surrounding yourself with people that no longer serve you or your life purpose. Okay, these people outside of yourself you may view as they are trying to hurt me, they are trying to attack me, but really what's going on is that your inner self is saying, you know what, they no longer help me with my life mission. They no longer help me in my life process. And by being with them, I'm not growing, okay? By being with them, I am feeling fear, okay? So whenever we're starting to feel this way, this is simply a wake-up call letting us know we need to move on. Time to change who I'm around, time to change what I'm about, right? It's time to change my inner energy because I'm operating out of fear. So much fear that I'm staying with this same group of people, allowing them to treat me a very certain way. And remember, guys, we can't point the finger and say, it's your fault. Why are you being mean? Why are you treating me like this? Let's be empowered here. Let's take some empowerment out of this and instead say, why am I allowing this to happen? Heck no, like I am out, you know what I mean? I do not have to stand for this. I can change me. I can change my life. I don't have to be surrounded by people like this, right? Let's take power this year, all right? So if you're dreaming about that and you're feeling fear, you know, be thankful that you have this dream because it's a wake-up call that it's time for you to make a change. It's time for you to surround yourself with newer energies, with different people, with people that are more in your life path, okay? And let's send these other people loving energy so that way they have time to grow as well. Remember, we always want to send them loving energy. Now, let's go to the third dream. Flooding. Okay, so flooding. You guys have dreamt a lot about flooding. And let me just say this. A lot of you are from North Carolina or from, what was it, Florida, where there has been some flooding and all of that in 2019. So guys, remember, if you see a lot of flooding in your waking life and you're fearful of it, you're concerned, whatever, if it's on the news, a lot of the time, if you're concerned or it's in your subconscious, it's going to creep up in your dream state, okay? So this is why I say it's so important to know what you're feeling during the dream because your feelings are going to guide you. If in the dream you see this flooding, and it's reminding you of a scene that you saw in your waking life, or you're fearful of it and you're connecting it with what's going on in your waking life, that's simply all it is, okay? It's just your fear of the flooding, of that situation, of how people react in that kind of scenario, right? That's what that is, right? But now, if you're in a state where there hasn't been any flooding, you haven't really seen much flooding on the news, but you're having this dream, remember that the water is a representation of our emotions, Okay, it's a representation of how we're feeling. It's a representation of being submerged in those feelings. Okay, so every little thing with a dream is like, you can't just give it one interpretation, right? You can't just do that. It really depends on that dreamer. It depends on what that dreamer is feeling. It depends on how they live their lives, on what it is that they're viewing, what energy they surround themselves with. You can't just take like a dream dictionary and say flooding, this is what my dream means, because that person isn't in your shoes and that person isn't living your life, right? So that's why I say it's so important to understand your dream language. And to do that, you have to understand yourself. Okay, you have to understand what's going on around you, what you're allowing to come into your life. So if you're dreaming about flooding, first think about it. What is going on around me? Am I viewing a lot of this? If yes, it can have a reflection to do with what's going on in my waking life, and I'm carrying this fear into my dream state. But now if I haven't seen a lot of flooding and I'm not in one of those states that floods frequently, but I'm dreaming about being in this flood and there's a lot of water, okay? You can interpret that as your emotional state, okay? A lot of the time when you dream about water, it's simply that, and especially if you're in the flood, if you're submerged by the water, it's those kinds of feelings, like those feelings are overwhelming you. So whatever feeling you are feeling when you're in this flood, that is the energy that's overwhelming you right now. And remember guys, it's not enough to know the interpretation of your dream, but it's just the first step. It's like, okay, now I know what this means. What am I going to do about this so that I can empower myself and do something about this so that way it can reflect in my waking state? Okay, because remember, that is why we interpret our dreams, so that we can live a better and more loving life. All right, let's go to the fourth one. Do, 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 do. Oh wait, 1, 2, 3, 4. We're on the fifth one. Oh, that's great. Okay, passing away. People that have passed away. This one is like the most popular. That's why I did this one last, okay? So a lot of you are dreaming of people that have passed away. And as you know, guys, in the dream world, you can access past, you can access present, you can access future, and you can even access dimensions above and dimensions below the dream world, okay? And a lot of this are those people that have passed away. So it depends again on how you're feeling whenever you're dreaming this. But if you dream of someone that has passed away in your life and you have just like a good feeling and you like to see them and you just feel content, they're simply there just letting you know, I am here, my energy continues, my body is gone, but my energy continues, and I just want you to know that, okay? And guys, if you're able to have a lucid dream, if you're aware that you're dreaming, and if you find yourself with this person that has passed away, you can ask them anything that you want, okay? Ask them whatever it is that you want, because they will be able to respond to you, and then you'll have, you know, all the answers that you're looking for. Now, if you're dreaming of someone that has passed away and it's causing you fear and you're like, oh my gosh, I don't want to see this, I don't know why I'm dreaming about this, and you don't enjoy it, that's a little bit different, okay? Because it's simply letting us know that you're operating out of fearful energy right now. So that's why we're always saying, let's move into loving energy when we interpret our dreams, because we don't want to increase fear. We want to increase love. We want to increase peace, all right? But if you're dreaming of someone that has passed away and it's causing you fear, the first thing is, you know, why am I fearful? Why is this particular individual causing me fear? A lot of the time, it's just something that is unknown to us, right? Especially if it's your first time dreaming of someone that has passed away, you're like, what is going on? This isn't right. This is very strange. But it's simply the fear of the unknown. Again, if you're able to have a lucid dream, simply ask, what is it that you're trying to tell me? What is it that you need from me? All right? Because this will take the fear out of it. You'll start just like a regular conversation, and it'll be just like any other dream, okay? So whenever you dream of loved ones that have passed away, or even other, you know, other people's family members that have passed away, it's okay. They simply are there to just say hello, let you know that their energy continues. And like I said, if you're able to have a lucid dream, just ask them. Just ask them, what is your message? What am I supposed to do for you or with you? Like, what is this? Why are you here, right? You'll be very surprised on what they say to you. I've had a lot of people that have told me that they've had like full-blown conversations with like their great-grandmothers, their great-great-great-great-grandfathers, and it's really, really cool to hear about that. It's really amazing. I've had one dreamer that she she asked like her, I think it was like great-great-great-grandfather, a couple of questions like about the family, and she found out like some stuff that was going on with the family, and it was actually real. Like that's whenever I was like, oh my gosh, that's like, that's crazy, that's amazing, you know. And she just found out some stuff that was going on within the family that she didn't understand before, but now she like connected the clues. And anyway, it kind of freaked her family out, but she loved it because she opened her arms, she opened her heart with loving energy, and she just kind of accepted the information as it was, right? Because what happens is whenever we operate out of loving energy, we're just not fearful anymore. We're not fearful of those things that we don't know about, the unknown, right? Because we start wanting to know, we start wanting to learn about it, all right? So guys, I appreciate you sending all of your dreams for 2019. It looks like what we're dreaming about, you know, exploring a house, exploring ourselves, right? Driving, taking control of our own lives, the snakes. Whenever we dream about this, if we're fearful of them, it's just letting us know, you know, it's time to change things. It's time to surround ourselves with people that have like more of our energy, more of our loving energy. Excuse me with my cold. At flooding, whenever we dream about flooding, again, reflect it outward and see, you know, is this something that's going on around me? Am I carrying this fear into my dream state? Or are the emotions in here driving me so much that I am just submerged in my emotions? What emotion am I submerged in, and what can I learn from this dream? Then the one about passing away, remember that they're here to just give you a message. Their energy continues. They just want to connect with you. And remember, just accept it with loving energy, because that is what we're here to do, right? We're here to continue to grow as individuals and as a community. So come 2020, guys, we are going to continue to interpret our dreams, to connect with our subconscious so that we can understand what is going on at that profound level. Because remember, guys, a lot of the time we start asking other people for advice and we're like, what should I do with this? What should I do with this? When if we took some moments to just, you know, kind of quiet our mind, connect with ourselves, and just listen to what our dreams are telling us, we could literally have all of the answers we wanted. All of the answers are within us, okay? So remember that, empower yourself for 2020, know that you have the answers, and simply listen to your subconscious through your dreams, okay? And remember, I am here to help guide you through this, but I want you to be empowered. I want you to understand your own dream language, okay? Because that's the only way that you're going to really be able to connect with yourself in your waking life and in your sleep state. All right, guys, I send you a huge hug. I send you love, unity, and peace for 2020. We will be in contact. Bye, guys.